Manga spoilers ahead! You have been warned, folks!
Inosuke! The Demon Slayer Corps' wildest new recruit! Has to be the craziest Demon Slayer ever to grace the Nitsu's timid consciousness! Inosuke's getup is so out there that our poor little yellow-headed Manzel in distress thinks our boar-headed friend is actually a demon inhabiting the building he's supposed to be clearing! So Nitsu can't help but cower in the face of such chadness!
Who can blame him, though? Inosuke, being completely unrefined and downright terrifying at first glance, was raised by a pack of wild boars! How'd this come about, you might ask? Before the final selection never took place, Inosuke had a rough childhood, just trying to survive with no help at all from his late mother.
Thanks, Mom!
She spent her years doing menial tasks, such as running away from an abusive husband, joining the Eternal Paradise cult, torturing Inosuke's infant ears with bad singing, subsequently fleeing said cult, because, you know, who could have saw that coming, throwing her own child into a river, and finally being devoured by the second of the upper moons, Doma! Between witnessing that clusterfuck and being raised by a bunch of wild animals, it's no wonder Inosuke's so messed up! Anyone would be a little touched in the head after all that. It's nothing short of a miracle that he retained any sanity at all! Be sure to thank all the kind village folk who offered to teach him a spot of human language while growing up for that. It must have been a nice distraction while spending literally years in the mountains, developing a self-taught style called Breath of the Beast! It's all thanks to Inosuke's perseverance that the Demon Slayer Corps added this wild card member to replenish their ever-dwindling ranks! If anyone knows how to make a big entrance, it's Inosuke. His grand debut was off the wall. Literally, he jumped through a wall, sideways, chasing six of the Lower Moon Kyogai, while still wielding his ridiculous Nichirian blades. Anyone who knows anything about fantasy blades knows there's a snowball's chance in hell that blade would work in real life. Not only has Inosuke royally pissed off the blacksmith who forged his blades by chipping away parts of them, he's more than likely compromised the blade's durability. In reality, those artificial teeth would snag on the first bone they came across, fail to cut through anything but mere flesh, and be more or less completely useless. But anime logic dictates that Inosuke's level of pure badassery overrides any form of crude logic! After all, thinking isn't Inosuke's strong point, and neither is mine! I just headbutted the table. And I don't know why. As I was saying, thinking isn't Inosuke's strong point. Slicing through any obstacle in his way with sheer strength is! Usually, except when it's not. As proven by the fifth of the Lower Moon, Rui's father, when Inosuke has failed to cut through his arm. But don't worry, all Inosuke had to do is try twice as hard, with twice as many blades to achieve success. One blade is for losers, like Tanjiro and Zenitsu, while two blades are for cool-ass pigmen who get things done! Make way for this choo-choo train of a man as he railroads his way through anything in his path like a total beast! You best hope you don't end up on Inosuke's shit list, cause his self-taught beast-breathing style allows his spidey senses to tingle halfway up the mountain and back! He's best known to use Seven Fangs special awareness to identify the position of enemies by feeling the small disturbances in the air. If you're a demon hiding in a forest full of monsters, you can officially consider yourself screwed! Inosuke will sniff you out and use Third Fang, rip and devour to chop your head off and kill your demon ass. That is, unless you're a creepy demon spider that's one of the 12 demon moons. In which case, you'll probably be fine, because he didn't even seem to be able to defeat Daddy Strong Arms without some help. Thus, consequently, and accidentally leaving Tanjiro to die. But who needs him, right? Not when you've got a Inosuke in the medieval pub making all the girls thirsty with his feminine good looks. We already know he's going to be using his excellent social skills to seduce the ladies. And by social skills, I mean acting like a crazed drug fiend on a crack binge. Naked in some unnamed forest. Upon first impression, Inosuke comes off as kind of a bully for beating the crap out of Zenitsu. But there's a demon in a box, and that crazy yellow belly wants to protect it for some reason. Do you know how ridiculous that sounds? Think about it this way. You spent your whole life training to become the most dangerous demon slayer humanly possible. And now, one of your fellow members is protecting a demon, an evil creature you've dedicated your entire life to eradicating. Like what? Are you crazy? I would have done the same thing if Tanjiro hadn't shown up like he owns the place. But how could he own the place when Inosuke owns all the places? Inosuke is best boar, and no single blade-wielding Tanjiro is going to dethrone him. There can only be one best boy in the Demon Slayer house, and Inosuke's gotta show him who's boss.
And thus, his rivalry with Tanjiro began, with swords a-swinging, fists a-flying, and ribs a-breaking! But for some reason, Tanjiro doesn't know they're rivals yet, because he's trying to think of his brain bits. Unlike Inosuke, who's thinking on a whole nother level. What kind of level, you ask? A primal, animalistic level of sheer instinct and finesse, to which Tanjiro could never understand, because Inosuke is better than Tanjiro in every conceivable way! Anything you can do, I can do better. Might as well be Inosuke's motto, because he can do all the things better, like throwing them hands, done headbutting you in the face, done throwing his enemies up a tree, done collapsing from exhaustion and receiving a concussion to the head, possibly resulting in permanent brain damage, done! Needless to say, Inosuke is a fan favorite who doubles as best boar, now and always. Khaleesi got clapped, but my boy got stacked. At first glance, you might have thought he was a chiseled man bae possessed by a spirit of a beastly boar, but in reality, he's a demon slayer, built to be a pure, unadulterated badass of over-the-top awesomeness! No matter how many times anyone beats him down, he'll always get right back up and show you what he's made of. And that's something we can all appreciate. What an unfiltered amount of pure joy and laughter he brings us with his goofy hat and can-do attitude is something to be admired. And that's why Inosuke is best for.